Hello all, this video is for those who have some confusion regarding the pressure belts and the cells. Okay, so if we talk about equator and let's talk about the earth as a whole. So this is your equator, this is 90 degree, this is 60 degree, this is 30 degree. Okay, so this is your equator and this is your atmosphere. Let this be a tropopause. Okay, so this is the tropopause, which is acting as a lid to the troposphere. Now this is the equator. Here at the equator there is high temperature. The air would rise up from the surface to the tropopause. Okay, beyond the tropopause the air cannot rise. So what happens? Because the air is rising here, then it will move along the tropopause. As the air reaches around 30 degree, okay, it is cooling. So once the air cool downs, it sinks to the surface back again. So when the air is sinking at around 30 degree, then one air current would move towards the equator and the other air current is moving towards the polar areas. Not yet reached the pole, but moving towards the polar areas. And now imagine this as the, this is the polar area. This is the high pressure condition here. Okay, low temperature and a high pressure condition here. So the air moves away from high pressure. Here the air is moving away from the polar areas. So air, one air current which is coming from your tropics and the other air current is coming from the polar areas. Both these air currents are mixing here. Okay, because they are mixing, obviously the air will actually go somewhere and it will rise up. So the air will rise up here. Okay, as the air is rising here, there would be a low pressure belt would be formed. Right, so here the air has risen and then it is again moving along the tropopause, completing these two cells. So this becomes your Hadley cell, this becomes your feral cell, this becomes your polar cell. Let us understand the movement of the air and along these cells. So here is the equator, the air is rising, moving along the tropopause, cooling down and sinking at around 30 degree. And then one air current is moving here towards the pole and the one air current is moving towards the equator. This is your completing one cell. And the direction of the air on the surface is like this. Okay, so it is like this, like this. So I'm taking this here, air is from the tropics to the equator in the form of the easterly winds, right? Coming on to this cell, this air current which has sinked down from at around 30 degree and is moving towards the pole, and then it has again risen up, okay, and then it is moving here. So this is nothing but the feral cell. If I see here, this is the low pressure because the air was rising here. So this is your subpolar low pressure belt. If we see the movement of the air along the surface, it is in this direction. The direction here is westerly. So the movement of the wind from the tropical high pressure to the subpolar low pressure is westerly. And if I talk about the polar cell, wherein the movement of the air is from the poles towards the subpolar low pressure, is in the this direction, which is easterly in this direction. So the movement of the air from the polar high pressure to the subpolar low pressure is easterly in direction, and this is your polar cell.